اللهم اهدنا الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد ثم اما بعد موضوع اليوم the topic of today the one of the most important topic to all the human being to every single and that's called التوحيد or العقيدة. There is no excuses for any Muslim to not learn about the توحيد and عقيدة. Why this subject? It's very important and mandatory, obligatory upon every single one. Some kinds of ibadah or subjects can be not mandatory for upon every single person. But the tawheed must every single one, men or women, to know about. Why? First of all, this is the only target Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created jinn and ants. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala summarizes in the surah, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا. I don't have created the jinn and ants except to serve or to worship me. So this is the goal from the creation. The goal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and the jinn to only worship Him. And this dunya is just like a tool or a mean to lead you to the hereafter. Not to stay on it. To use it for your deen, to use it for your tawheed, to use it for your Islam. But number one, it's very important because this is the why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. He didn't create us to eat, drink, kids, wealth, enjoy, then die. No. He created us to worship Him. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent all these prophets and the messengers and revealed the books or the messages the human being and to the jinn for tawheed. The main message, the priority message for every single prophet and messenger, an abudullah la ilaha ghayru, to worship one God, no any other God with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, and this is clear in all the ayat in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From Nuh to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the main message, all people, worship your Lord, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not associate or take any partner with Allah. Number one, this is the main goal for the creation. Number two, the main of the prophets and the messengers, and they reveal the books. Number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created heavens, earth, paradise, hellfire, just for that issue. How? Who will enter the paradise? The muwahideen, the believers, from any nations, who worship one God, correct? And who will enter the hellfire and be forever in the hellfire? Those who disbelieve in Allah, who died as non-believer, died as infidels, has partners or associations with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can imagine that all of that just for the tawheed. That's why it's very, very important that you know about the tawheed. What else? This is also the right Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon his slaves. حق الله على العباد. And the famous hadith, as we're going to see inshallah, just this introduction. So inshallah we're going to give the details through the Kitab al-Tawheed and some other books as well, Usul al-Thalatha and so on and so on. When the Prophet told Mu'adh, do you know what is the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon his slaves and what the rights of the slaves upon the Lord? He said, Allah wa Rasulullah A'lam. Allah and his messengers know best. He said, Haqqullahi al-Ibad. Allah's right upon his slaves to worship alayhi salam, to worship him. To do not associate anyone with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the rights of the slaves, of the servants, of the people, or the most of the believers upon the Lord, if they will do that, they will admit them to paradise. So this is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he's the creator, he is the one who created you. You have to show the sincerity, the ikhlas, the tawheed to him azza wa jal. Okay? He's the one who created you and give you all this favor and bounties and so on. So his rights is that you worship him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why it's very also important. Ayah in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's very secure. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah would never, ever forgive for anyone who died as a mushrik. But He subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive anything else. Whatever the limits, or whatever the amount of your sin, when you meet your Lord, but you was muwahid, you wasn't a mushrik, Allah easily can forgive it to you. هذا في حديث القدسي المشهور. يا ابن آدم لو أنك أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني لا تشرك بي شيئا لأتيتك بقرابها مغفرة. O son of Adam, if you will meet me in the day of judgment with the earth full of cardinal, major, great sin, but you meet me as a muwahid, I will forgive you. أَمَّا لَقِيتَنِي لَا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا غَفَرْتُهَا لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. I will forgive it, all of it for you, and I don't care. So, that's very important that I have to know if I have tawheed or I have a shirk. Tons, a huge number of the Muslims these days, they fall in shirk. And most of them, they don't know. They say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They recite and memorize the Quran. They know haram and halal. They pray, they saw and hajj. But they have a lot of things of shirk or adhu wa ta'ala. So that's will not benefit them, all of this kind of worship with the shirk. They go to the graves, they worship those in the graves, they make dua, they ask them to cure them, to give them benefits in this dunya, so on, so on, so. And when you invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you invoke someone else, that's shirk. They sacrifice with them. If you sacrifice with anyone else but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's shirk, and so on and so on and so on. And that's shirk akbar. Yani I'm gonna see inshallah that the types of shirk. This is shirk akbar. What means shirk akbar? Big shirk that will take you out of the Islam. Riyah, to show up, it's a kind of shirk, but this is small shirk. But when you go to the graves and have khushu'a, you are humble and ask the people in the graves, oh, my son is sick, please cure him, oh, so and so, please. When you slaughter for them, you slaughter for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for those. When you make nadr, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for those. So all of these attacks, big shirk, wa'l-a'adhu billahi ta'ala. So this is why, dear brothers and sisters, it's very, very important to know about the tawheed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed in Mecca 13 years. The age, the period of da'wah is 23 years. More than half of it, 65% or 70%, was in Mecca just for establishing the foundation of tawheed. 13 years in Mecca. La ilaha illallah. Qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. No any war, no any fighting. Most of the ibadat, salah, zakah, hajj, and so on, later on, like after 9 years, like 7 years, like when they went to the Medina, the rules of the khamr, the rules of soda, the most important things, those in Mecca, tawheed, la ilaha illallah. So avoid the shirk. The fear that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what the Prophet did in Mecca. So if that's not important, he will not spend more than the half of the period of the age of the time of da'wah just for the tawheed. And he was so patient for all types of torturments from the mushrikeen just to make sure that the sahaba has the tawheed side. And once they are, alhamdulillah, established the tawheed, they immigrate to Mecca, to Medina, and establish the Muslim society and the activity and so on. So that means it's not wasting time that you spent a couple of years of your age to know about the tawheed. And we don't mean that you study book and you do not practice. That will not benefit you. Brother, what's tawheed? 1, 2, 3, 4. What's type of tawheed? 1, 2, 3, 4. What's so and so? And the evidence, so. But you do not practice tawheed. And you do the shirk. That will not benefit you. No, tawheed is not just to memorize something or to recite it 1, 2, 3. No, to practice that. As we said, how many Muslims? They know a lot of things. But they obey tahut, they obey shayateen, they obey the ants instead of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that shirk. They innovate a new methods of worship, this kind of shirk. Why? Because Allah is the only one who is the innovator subhanahu wa ta'ala or creator or so on and so on. You cannot do something like that, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-hukmu wal-amr lillahi azwain al-hukmu illa lillah. Ilayhi irja al-amr kullu. All of this for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cannot be for the human being. That's why the Prophet spent 13 years, full 13 years in Mecca to establish the foundation of the tawheed. So, believe me, brothers, because some people, some groups, they say tawheed, tawheed, tawheed. Yes, tawheed is very important. Of course, also will not go to the other way, extreme other way, just I said for tawheed and that's it, and do not know anything about my deen. No, this is not the meaning. But the priority, the tawheed. And as well, the Quran, you have to know about it. The fiqh of how you pray, how you saw in Ramadan, how you deal if you are a trader, to do not fall in riba. So and so, so you have to, if you are going to marry, you have to know the rules of marriage and so on. So it's very important to know all the aspects of that deen, but the most priority one, you have to give more time and more priority, the tawheed. Because if you died any time and you don't know what is the tawheed and you are falling shirk or a'udhu billahi ta'ala, that's scary and very dangerous. This is why it's very important that you know the tawheed and to practice the tawheed like the sahaba, Radwanullahi ta'ala, Radwanullahi ta'ala alayhi.